Required by the hand and the supporters at the end of that game. What is your message to them after 3 months?
My message was the same message of the supporters. The message that the supporters gave to the players was my message. It was the same. When you play the way you play, when you create what you create, when you miss the chances that we missed, when at half time everybody was frustrated but totally convinced that was going to win the match. And even with the unexpected 2-0 result, the way the team kept playing until the third goal arrived, my message to the players has to be a positive message. And I'm really happy, humbled by the way the supporters reacted to the voice. I think it was very much deserved, but sometimes players deserve and they don't get what they deserve, so we have to be humbled by the supporters' reaction to the team.
Jose, are you concerned by these two defeats from the first three games? Is there a worry there that your team could be on the slide?
You know, I wouldn't be worried if at half-time we were winning 3-0. And at half-time the result should be 3-0. 3-1, 2-0. But we were so much the best team in the first half that I wouldn't be worried with that.
Jose, what went wrong in the second half? Because everything looked on track at half-time.
Everything was what?
Everything looked on track, everything looked okay at half-time, so...
Yeah.
So what went wrong in the second half?
Did you see the goal?
Jose, do you know what your best back four is at the moment?
No.
Hello?
No.
You don't?
No.
Why not?
Why don't?
Yeah.
Because in the first game played Lindelof and Bailly, and today played Jones and Smalling, but now Jones is injured, and in the next match will be Smalling with another one, and when Marcos Rojo come will be also an option. And no, I don't know my best back four.
Is it affecting them by changing them a lot. Taking players in, taking players out, is that affecting the confidence in the way they defend?
No.
Jose, if you play a midfielder in the back three ahead of Lindelof, does that not affect Lindelof's confidence? Is it just you don't trust him in the back three?
You want to make the miracle of my team played so well and strategically we were so good, and you want to try to transform this press conference in a situation of let's blame the guy. I'm sorry, you have to tell me what is the most important thing, because I don't know. Because when I win matches, I come here many times and you are not happy that I won matches, and you say that the most important thing is the way of playing.
I'm just asking about the defense.
No, you have to make a decision in relation to that, because I need to know from you what is the most important thing, if it is to play well or if it is to win matches.
I think
if it is to play offensively or is to play for a certain result. Today we were aggressive, we pressed high, Tottenham couldn't make two passes coming from the back, they made lots of mistakes because of our pressure high. We project the fullbacks. We had Valencian and Luke Shaw arriving in dangerous positions. We miss goals with an open goal. We miss chances. We were unlucky in rebounds in both goals. We lost the game because we conceded a goal in the first corner of the match against us on the minute 50 something. In the first half, zero corners, zero lateral free kicks, zero frontal free kicks. On the minute 50-something, they had one corner, they score a goal. And you want, with that goal, you want to transform You want to transform the story of the game. But don't lose your time, because today I had the proof that the best judge in football are the supporters. They are the best judge.
But many of the supporters walked out.
Yeah?
Towards the end. So
I'll do the same. Losing 3-0.
Yeah, so
losing 3-0. Taking 2 hours from here to the center of Manchester, because it's where I live and I know that after matches it takes 2 hours, I'll do the same. So keep trying. Keep trying. We lost last season here against Sevilla and we were booed. Because we deserve. Because we were not good. Because we were not dangerous enough. Because Sevilla deserved to win the match. We were booed. And deservedly. And today the players, they left the pitch after losing at home and they were applauded because they deserve it. So you keep trying and trying and trying and keep trying. And keep trying.
Is it not a bit of a distraction?
Okay,
yes.
Now, just to finish, do you know that what was the result? 3-0.
You lost
3-0. 3-0. Do you know what this means? 3-0. But also mean 3 premierships, and I won more premierships alone than the other 19 managers together. 3 for me and 2 for them. Respect, 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 man, respect, 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 man.